Mark Devine. We find you guilty of murder and of writing a symphony in honor of Satan to win from him the gift of eternal life.
Carlota!
Master! Master! He's innocent! Let him go! He's innocent!
This is your last chance, John Octavia. Take now or join your master in hell.
You may rip me apart, you Philistines! But my music will outlive you all!
Master!
My bill and I'll be fine.
What you need is a bath.
Don't waste your time with him, mademoiselle. He's only a musician.
To my friend the constable here, the Mona Lisa's only a painting.
Would you kindly point the way to Chateau Cauchemar?
To do that would not be kindly at all. What on earth would take, young lady, there?
Why, my inheritance.
Don't tell me you're related to the Baron.
Yes, he was my great uncle.
If I were you, I wouldn't hold my head quite so high, mademoiselle.
Will you tell us the way or not?
Only God can do that. Come on.
Welcome to Cauchemar, mademoiselle. I'm Carlotta, the housekeeper.
Thank you, Carlotta. Were you here when my great-uncle...
Yes, I came when I was 16.
Carlotta, what is behind that wall?
was the entrance to Baron's recital hall.
Well, why on earth is it bricked up?
By orders of the church, mistress.
They really did believe he composed a symphony for the devil, didn't they?
Yes. Let me show you your room.
Where the Baron did most of his composing, Carlotta?
Most of it. Yes.
And that must be him.
Yes.
Sadly, we can never bring him nor his compositions back. But we could take the boards off the windows and tune the piano and fill this house with music once again. Carlotta, what's the matter?
I never thought I'd see this day.
Thank you. mademoiselle. Have you discovered one of your uncle's compositions?
Oh, not just a composition. A work of genius. Oh. It's passionate and innovative. Intricately structured. Oh, in fact, it's so good I wish to have it played at my wedding.
It has no ending.
Oh, well, that needn't deter us. I know dozens of composers in Paris. I shall simply hire one to finish it before my fiancé's arrival.
Your uncle would be very pleased. Another rejection?
Gaston Chevrier refuses even to look at my uncle's symphony.
You'll find another.
Whom? Everyone else has turned us down.
That's Marius Carnot, the choir master, paying off his debt to the tavern.
Barbaric.
They say that suffering enriches the soul. Maybe it will enhance his compositions.
He's a composer?
For God's sake, man, can't you bring me just one small drink?
Marius Connell? How do you do? I am Gabrielle Apollinaire, and I understand drinking is what brought you here.
And what brings you here? This place is hardly fit for a young lady.
Nor for a choir master. I have inherited an unfinished symphony, and I wish to hire you to complete it. I'm offering you your freedom.
What good is freedom to a man with no money?
Of course you shall be paid. But I warn you, you are no good to me intoxicated.
And I'm no good to myself sober.
Then I am sorry to have wasted your time, Monsieur Connell. I thought you might want to compose again. But I can see now you only want to decompose.
Mademoiselle Apollinaire, wait!
Mata? Monsieur Carnot will be our guest for dinner tonight. And for some time to come, he has agreed to work on the symphony.
Very good, mistress. Monsieur, if you follow me, I'll show you to your quarters.
I'm glad to see this grim old house hasn't dampened your spirit.
Prison was grim. Thank you, Carlotta. But here, I feel very much at home.
Yes, well, I'll feel more at home when these halls are filled with music.
Would you like some cognac, monsieur? This dates back to the Baron's time. Oh.
Very well. A small glass for Monsieur Carnot. And pour yourself one as well, Carlotta. Let's celebrate. The return of music to Chateau Cauchemar.
You obviously love music.
Yes, I studied at the conservatory in Paris.
The City of Light. But you left it?
Well, I had lived there my whole life, and after a time, I felt myself trapped. I know it sounds odd.
Oh, not at all. I would feel myself trapped anywhere were it not for my music.
And why is that?
Well, composers aren't bound by the same physical laws as others. For example, when I was in prison, I composed a waltz made entirely from bird songs. And when the birds flew from my window, my soul soared with them. Well, at least it tried.
Oh, I would love to hear this waltz.
Then you shall, mademoiselle.
There's the robin. And the swallow.
Is that the nightingale?
Yes, ma'am. You say so. But from tonight, it shall be known as Gabrielle's Waltz.
Nonsense. Oh, but it really is charming.
Charming, yes. But a symphony is quite another animal. Let's have a look at your uncle's noble work. Well done, everybody. Well, that's enough practice for today. The next rehearsal will be on Saturday.
Mr. Carno?
Yes, Yvette?
Did I hit the high note in my solo today?
Yes, it was splendid.
I wasn't flat?
No, Yvette. Your pitch is almost perfect.
Thank you.
have you been?
Suffocating in a cold act.
Come. Let me hold you.
Not yet. First, you must finish my symphony.
I'm old now. You won't want me anymore.
We will be reunited, my precious. I'll take that Dabbler's body, and you will have the girl's young body. When the score is complete. Adieu, my best. I have work to do.
Wait. What do you need, my love?
What I've always needed. Inspiration.
Monsieur. How well do you know yourself?
Lost all sense of time.
You've been drinking.
Yes, yes, I have. I'm sorry, Gabriella.
You are incorrigible. Well, at least you've written new measures. Will you play them for me?
Excellent. Excuse me, mademoiselle, but Monsieur Dupont has arrived.
Julian. Julian! Oh, thank you, Monsieur Carnot. Thank you, Carlotta.
Grown more beautiful every day since we've been apart.
So glad to see you. So tell me all about your journey.
It was endless. The coachman tried to entertain me by singing the entire way. Unfortunately, he was completely deaf to tone.
Well, you won't have to suffer anymore. Here we only have the most beautiful music.
Really? Ah, you've hired musicians.
Not musicians, a resident composer. I retained him to complete my uncle's symphony.
From what court?
He's a local man, but quite ingenious. I'll introduce you to him at dinner.
Well, splendid.
Yes, I'm fine. However, that does conclude today's rehearsal. Thank you. I'll see you all on Sunday. Thank you. Please help me.
Monsieur Carnot, I must confess that until today your name was unknown to me. With whom did you study?
Well, as a matter of fact, I'm self-taught.
Self-taught? Mm-hmm. In Paris, that means you're either one of two things, a genius or an amateur.
Oh, Julian, I can assure you, Monsieur Carnot is no amateur.
Really? It is then my privilege to be in the presence of a self-taught genius. Have you composed anything I should know?
I have no idea what you might know.
Monsieur Carnot played me a waltz of his last night.
Last night? A waltz. How interesting. And has this waltz had its debut?
Why, yes, it's performed every morning throughout the countryside.
Something amuses you, Gabrielle?
I am sorry, Julian. It's just that Michel Cano's waltz is composed of bird songs.
Bird songs? Throughout the countryside. Whatever next, monsieur? Concerto for the cowshed?
Oh, no, Julian. It's really quite lovely.
I'm sure that it is a local treasure. Perhaps you'll perform it for us after dinner.
No, Monsieur Dupont. I don't believe I shall.
Oh. Why ever not?
I've already auditioned for the job. Quite successfully, I believe. Good night to you, sir. Mademoiselle.
Did I start things off on the wrong foot?
Excuse me. Mademoiselle, Tristan Duval is here.
The constable.
And I have already told you, Monsieur Duval, that I spent the entire night in this room.
Is that so, Monsieur? And you didn't go out to get a drink?
Constable, did you really come all the way out here just to accuse this man of having a drink?
I'm accusing him of strangling a whore with a piano wire.
What?
Well, were you at the tavern last night or not?
No, of course not.
And this piano wouldn't be missing any wires, would it?
Constable Duval, this piano is perfectly tuned, and I can assure you that every part is in its proper place.
Is that so?
Monsieur, if my fiancée says that it is so, then it is so. Now, I must ask you to leave immediately.
Very well. Good evening, mademoiselle.
Gabrielle, darling, may I have a word with you in private?
This is the limit, Gabrielle. What kind of person have you invited into our house?
Don't tell me you take the constable's accusations seriously. Julian, I assure you, they're unfounded.
Regardless, I don't like this Carno fellow, and I will not allow him to spend another minute here.
Julian, you're being unfair.
Unfair?
Darling, our wedding day should be the happiest day of our lives. I want everything to be perfect, including the music. Now, why can't we have a bit of cheerful Italian music like everyone else?
But I don't want to be like everyone else.
Gabrielle, what's more important to you? That man and his damned symphony or me?
Well, you are, dear, of course.
Thank you. Now, do you wish to tell him he's leaving first thing in the morning, or shall I?
I'll tell him.
I do love you, darling.
I came to see if you'd like a glass of port.
I don't think so.
The bottle's over 200 years old.
Actually, that would be nice. Thank you.
Not nearly as sorry as I.
Well, of course your commission will still be paid in full.
It's not the money that concerns me. It's not even the symphony that concerns me.
Well, what then?
Gabrielle.
Your port, sir.
I'm engaged to be married.
I know. And it breaks my heart.
To your health.
Julian, what are you doing here?
I know I'm not a talented musician, but I can't understand your fascination with your uncle's symphony. It doesn't make sense to me.
I can't understand what you're saying.
You don't love me.
I do love you.
Yes, but I want you to love only me.
Please, Julian, not like this.
How dare you?
This is outrageous, invading the privacy of a lady's boudoir.
I'm sure the lady would agree.
You insult me, monsieur. Don't you think I know what's going on here? I saw you in the garden.
Both of you, go.
I demand satisfaction.
What?
Ah, Monsieur Carnot. There's no need to pray now. You'll be talking to God soon enough.
Now, Monsieur Carnot, you should cross yourself and pray.
Duncan, how can you do this?
Says you're going to be fine.
What about Julian? Carlotta, what happened to Julian?
You killed him. Julian could do to defend himself.
I don't understand. Gabriel, I killed him.
Shh. You're not to blame.
I've lost you.
No. You haven't lost me. I will be back from the funeral as soon as I'm able.
Devil. I can't wait.
When are you in there?
Get out!
But...
Gabrielle. Thank God you're back.
Marius, you shouldn't be out of bed. You should be resting.
Gabrielle, I'm frightened. Something is happening inside me. I no longer trust my own senses. God in heaven, I never even dreamed of killing a man before I came into this house.
But you were acting in self-defense.
Was I? And why do I have no memory of it? And why, when I hear your uncle's music, does my head fill with terrible visions of violence and perversion?
Because you suffered a serious injury. What you need is rest.
What I need is to be locked inside the recital hall until I finish your uncle's symphony.
Ridiculous. Where would you sleep?
At the piano. And I want no food nor drink. And please, do not open the door under any circumstances.
Do I know you?
Well, now that all depends. How well do you know yourself? Well, now. And what do they call you?
A lot of things. My name is Louis.
Come here, my lovely. Sing!
Monsieur, I'm tone deaf. I don't even like music.
Do you know who I am?
Well, you're not Ludwig friggin' Beethoven, that's for sure.
Thank you.
quick. Let's come in and see me. Come on. They play us this time.
You stop or I'll shoot! Turn around and show yourself.
You some breakfast. And I don't care how crazy you are, Marius Carnot. I'm not going to let you starve.
Gabrielle, wait. We must talk.
About what?
It's just that I've never really written anything other than bird songs and the like. Now that I'm working in this fantastic music, as if all the demons buried in my soul are emerging.
But that sounds exciting.
Exciting? Exciting? Do you know what I dreamed last night?
Yes, Carlotta, what is it?
Constable Duval is here to see Master Marius.
Marius Carnot, you are under arrest for the murder of Louise Cador and for the attempted murder of an officer of the law. Will you come quietly?
I am tired of your persecution of Monsieur Carnot. Constable Duval, when did these supposed crimes take place?
Last night, and I have the wounds to prove it.
And I can personally vouch that Monsieur Carnot was in this house all last night.
How is that possible, mademoiselle?
Did you sleep with him?
How dare you impugn this lady's honor?
The descendants of Baron Octavia have no honor to impugn.
Show me your evidence linking Monsieur Carnot to these crimes, or get out!
This is not Paris, madam. I don't need any evidence.
But it is France, Constable Duval. And as long as I have friends in the Ministry of Justice, you will observe the code of Napoleon. Now leave.
Marius Carnot, I knew you were a criminal the moment I laid eyes on you. I intend to see you suffer the same fate as the man whose symphony you've been hired to complete.
What did he mean, Gabriel? What happened to the Baron?
Do you really wish to know?
I must know.
He was lynched by a mob. The local bishop didn't care for his music, and so he convinced the entire town that he was writing a symphony in honor of Satan.
You hired me to complete a symphony glorifying the devil?
There is no devil. They murdered the Baron for his musical style.
Very style. It
reason to complete the symphony. I should have listened to Julian. I'll have the balance of your commission for you tomorrow. You are free to go.
I was just...
Just eavesdropping. Well, perhaps you'd like to join Monsieur Carnot when he leaves tomorrow.
No.
Then stop creeping around this house like some kind of ghoul.
If Monsieur Carnot so much as sets foot out of this house, one of you is to follow him and the other is to notify me. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Carlotta. Carlotta, what's happening? You've lost control of them.
I'm going to be stuck in this rotting shell till I die.
That's a wonderful idea. We shall finish my symphony together. Die for me, my pet, that we both may be reborn. Let's go and find the woman.
By the authorities?
No.
Good. Then we mustn't tell anyone, Marius. Not a soul.
What are you saying?
If the constable learns of this, he'll hang us both.
No, but we're innocent. She committed suicide.
Do you really think that'll matter to him? After Julian and the two whores? We'll say that I dismissed her. That she left this house without saying a word.
I'm leaving myself, Gabrielle. Tonight.
That's what you think.
What did you say?
This house will be lonely without you, Marius.
suppose there's nothing more to say.
There's something that I'd like to say, Marius.
Yes.
I don't want you to leave.
Why not?
Because I think I love you. Something for me, Marius, if I asked you. It would mean a great deal to me.
Anything. You know I'd do anything for you, Gabriel, anything.
I'd like to hear you play my uncle's music just one more time.
I don't think that would be a good idea.
Oh, but it's all I ask. And then we can run away together. To Paris, perhaps.
Yvette, I've come to see Miss O'Connor.
Why, yes. Please, come in.
Forgive me for arriving unannounced, monsieur. But I've been worried about you.
About me? How sweet. But what on earth are you worried about?
Well, you missed our last rehearsal, monsieur. And there is a killer on the loose.
A killer? And you came all the way here to make sure that I was safe.
Yes. Well, I can see you are safe, and I don't want to take up any more of your time.
Oh, nonsense. Why don't we make up for that choir practice I missed?
What? Now, monsieur?
Well, why not, seeing as you're here? And... Excellent. Now pick up the tempo. Faster. 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 Faster.
Carlotta! It's finished!
Who successfully completed my masterwork in honor of his satanic majesty that I might live again. A little encouragement, we can get this talented young man to play my new composition for us.
Protégé needs something a bit stronger than champagne. Carlotta, a glass of cognac.
Yes, master.
The pursuit of immortality requires many sacrifices.
It's true. My uncle was writing a symphony for the devil. And I forced you to complete it.
Not you, my love. Carlotta. You were possessed just as I was.
But how did we? Your walls have set us free.
I can never be free again. Not after what I've done.
But you're innocent. It wasn't you.
I don't feel innocent.
Yes? Henri! What is it?
Are you looking for your daughter?
Have you seen her?
Up at Chateau Cauchemar. She went inside and then... we thought we heard a scream.
Oh, my God!
Sound the alarm. Assemble as many armed men as possible. We're going to rid ourselves of this menace, Carnot, once and for all.
I can barely lift it.
It's yours no longer, my sweet.
My beautiful body. I can't control it. What's happening to me?
Your services here are no longer required, my lovely.
Your soul is on its way to hell. With all the other suicides.
The symphony. We were promised immortality.
No. I was promised immortality. You were promised nothing.
But you said I would be rewarded.
And you have been.
Amply. I stooped so low as to make love to you, didn't I?
You bastard!
Yes.
but now I'm a very young, very handsome bastard.
It's all over, isn't it?
Indeed it is. Love of my life.
Break the door.
Can you forgive me?
I forgive you anything, Morris. I love you.
Marius Kondo, you are under arrest for the murder of Yvette Fauxpas.
Goodbye, Gabriel.
Thank you.